Hello all. In this session, we are going to deal with the module 2, that is Advances in Engineering Systems. Firstly, that is photovoltaic cell. So what is photovoltaic cell? Like photovoltaic cell is also called as a solar cell, and also it is an electronic component that generates electricity when exposed to the photons or particles of light. And this conversion is called as the photovoltaic cell and photovoltaic effect. Okay, solar energy can be directly converted to the electrical energy by means of photovoltaic effect, and this EMF, that is the electromotive force, is defined as the generation of electromotive force, that is EMF, as a result of the absorption of ionizing radiation. And also photovoltaic capacity has been growing steadily since 21st century by the lead by the construction of huge solar farms. And also solar cells are semiconductors commonly used or barriers type, that is iron selenium cells. Okay, next one is wind turbine. Wind turbine is nothing but like it is referred as a wind energy converter, and also this device that converts the winds into kinetic energy, into electrical energy. And also this wind turbines are manufactured in wide range of vertical and horizontal axis. And also the smallest turbines are used, smallest turbines are used for application such as battery charging, or any, for example, small boats, and also traffic warning lights, etc. And also these large turbines can be used for making contributions to the domestic power supply while selling unused power bank to the utility supplier. And also like the arrays of large turbines known as the wind farms also. And wind energy is defined as the kinetic energy associated with the movement of large masses of air over the earth. And also it is then forced upwards by a cooler, denser air which flows from the surrounding areas, causing a wind. And the circulation of the air in the atmosphere is caused by the non-uniform heating of the earth's surface by the sun. And the air immediately above warm area expands and becomes less dense. Okay, so the renewable energy that are used in many countries as a strategy to reduce their the fossil fuels actually. Next one is hydropower plant, that is converts the potential energy into mechanical energy through the water turbines, which then generate the electricity. Okay, the hydroelectric power plant are also called as a dam or a hydropower plant, and also it is used for generation of electricity for the water on the large scale basis. And the dam is built across the large river, that is a flowing water, that has sufficient quantity of water throughout the year. And also the total power generation capacity of the hydraulic power plants depends on the head of the water and volume of the water flowing towards the water turbine. And also hydropower plant can be classified into three categories, that is runoff river and the storage, and also the pumped storage, and in the stream hydropower schemes. There are different schemes in the hydropower plant. And also in certain cases where the river is very large, more than one dam can be built across the river at different locations. The rainwater flowing as the river can be stored, and also behind the dams means in the inflow, where the inflow will take place there, and also released in the regulating way to generate the hydro power. And if we are seeing the working, working of the hydropower plant means the hydropower plants capture the energy of falling water to generate the electricity, and the turbine converts the kinetic energy of falling water into mechanical energy. and then a generator converts the mechanical energy from the turbine into the electrical energy. So this is the working principle of the excuse me hydropower plant. And also most hydroelectricity is produced at the large dams only, because the huge water supply is needed for this and built by the government authorities. And also many of the largest hydropower dams in the other countries also. And also about half of the total US like conventional hydroelectricity generation capacity is converted in the many Washington or in California, etc. And also if we are discussing about five advantages of the hydropower plant, that is renewable, that is hydropower is completely renewable, which means it will never run out the unless the water stops flowing. And also the emission free, and also very reliable and adjustable, and create the lakes. So these are the many advantages of the this one advantages of hydropower plant. And also a hydropower plant is completely renewable, which means it will never run out of unless the water stops flowing. And also as a result, like hydropower plants are built in some cases, like equipment that was built last like 25 years and still operational after the double the amount of time has passed. And the emission free, that is the creation of hydroelectricity does not release emission into the atmosphere. And this is of course the the biggest advantages for the renewable energy sources. And it is very much adjustable, like since hydro power is so reliable that the hydropower plants can actually adjust the flow of water. And also this allows the plant the two plants can actually adjust the flow of water, and this also the plant to produce the more energy when it is required, or reduce the energy output which is not needed. And this is something that no other renewable energy source can do this one. And also it creates the lakes. The lakes can be used for any other the recreation purpose, the fishing or like that, and can even can draw the the tourist. We can make it as a tourist spot. But look no further, like it created the result. For example, if I want to give an example of a dam, Hoover Dam, which is millions together visitors are visiting the place. And this can be nearby towns, the huge there will be a more economic to the economically where the country will be more good in this way. And if I want to talk about the disadvantages, like impact on the fishes, like to create the hydro power plant, that a running water source must be dammed. That is, running water must be, you have to secure, we have to secure that water. And this prevents fishes from reaching their breeding ground, which in turn affects any animals for their food. And as the water stops flowing, riverside habitats begin to disappear. And this can even remove animals from accessing the water. And also the higher initial cost, that is a major disadvantage of this hydroelectric power plant. Because while no power plant is easily we can build, because hydropower plants require like more cost, so it is costlier. And similarly a fossil like sized to the fossil fuel plant. And also like not to worry about the purchasing of fuel later, but does not over for the the long term will be more. And maybe the flood risk, like when the dams are built at like higher elevation, so then the serious risk of any of the nearby downstream side areas will be under risk. And while these dams are built very strong, there will be still risk. But the biggest dam failure history is I think very few. And due to the excess rainfall, maybe the collapse of the the dam may occur. And but hydropower plant is still growing, because the world begins to the fossil fuels, they want to reduce the fossil fuels for the energy. And it's worth nothing that the hydroelectric power plant should be built, and we need to use much more in the coming days. Thank you.